Hi everyone, today we're going to take a look at a suicide water heater. Now I call this a suicide water heater because if you try to make one of these yourself, the chances are you're going to kill yourself or you're going to kill someone else. So whatever you do, do not try and make this at home. And the reason why I made this is I wanted to test the idea of DIY water heaters, because back in war times people used to use razor blades and matches and then some wire to make DIY water heaters. Now I couldn't get hold of razor blades, or at least not the old style ones, so I'm just using two plugs, one that will plug into the wall and one that will go in the water to act as the electrodes to heat the water. Now again, don't try this at home because you'll probably kill yourself or kill someone else. So here I have a glass of water that we're going to warm up, and then here I have my regular socket. Now you'll notice some strangeness going on here. Instead of just plugging straight in, I'm going to plug into an RCD or GFCI, which gives me protection against electrocution. I still wouldn't want to touch the ends of this, but this should at least offer me some protection. So I'm going to start by putting one end into the water, and I'm just going to use a clip to hold it in place. And then the other end I'm going to plug into our socket. And then I'm going to turn on the water by pressing the reset button on my RCD. And then I'll zoom in on the water. You should see small bubbles appearing. Now it's hard to actually see the bubbles, so I'm going to move the camera closer. So you can see there are bubbles attached to the pins, and that's basically warming the water, believe it or not. Now this is hard to show on camera, but the water is actually starting to warm up. What I'll do is I'll plug in a watt meter so we can see how much power this is actually consuming. So I've now plugged my watt meter into my GFCI socket, and I'll just press the button to turn on the socket and swap to watts. So you can see we're only consuming around 35 watts. So this isn't a very fast heater. It's going to take quite a long time to actually heat any sizable amount of water. So let's try to remove it and then bend the pins closer together and see if we can increase this power consumption. And of course I am going to unplug it before I go near it. So let's bend these pins closer together. Now we don't want them to touch because that's going to make a very big bang. But we'll just move them close together like that. I'll put it back in the water, clip it in place, and now everything's plugged back in again, and I'll turn on our GFCI socket and let's see how much power we're consuming this time. So we're now at 45 watts, which isn't a huge increase, but it's an extra 10 watts or so. Now if we actually wanted to make this heat much faster, I think what we'd have to do is use bigger plates, because those two prongs are very small. Now it's been running for a couple minutes and you can see the power usage has increased quite a lot. We're now at 62 watts and the glass is so hot that I can barely actually touch it without burning myself, so I think this water will begin to boil pretty soon. Now I'm not sure if this glass is rated for high temperatures, so I'm going to try and move the electronics out of the way just in case this breaks. So you can see we've got quite a lot of bubbles going on now and a lot of steam, so I have a feeling this is going to start boiling soon. So we've now got a pretty healthy boil going on the water, and we're consuming around 95 to 97 watts, so quite a lot more power now. Now as I said earlier, this is called a suicide water heater for good reason, because trying to make and use one of these would be kind of suicidal. But for myself, as an experiment and share on the channel, I think it came out okay. But the first thing I'm going to do is take apart this cable so no one accidentally plugs it in and then electrocutes himself. So if you enjoyed this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching.